Last January, January 6th, the official day of the polar vortex, we experienced really damaging temperatures, anywhere from around 20 below zero to about 16 below zero, where it killed the fruiting buds and it killed actual grapevines. And we've never experienced any damage like this before. And we really didn't know the extent of the damage on the vines till April, May, in that time frame, when we didn't see any buds developing, and even some of the trunks cracked. So the impact of that was dramatic. We have no crop at all in our vinifera, and we grow varieties like Chardonnay, Pinot Noir, Cabernet Franc, Riesling, and without any grapes, we were forced to buy a lot of grapes. So it's had a huge impact as far as the grape production, not to mention the actual wine loss, which is 2 or 3 years spanning, because in some of the vineyards that have to be replaced from the ground up with new vines, we will not get a new, the first crop is 3 to 4 years out. So the impact is just dramatic, and millions of dollars.
Actually, in the viticulture program at Ohio State, one of our focus of research is cold hardness of grapes. So really, that's one of my expertise in this field of learning more about how grapes cope with freezing, with cold in general. After this cold event, our growers really need a lot of help in terms of how to not only assess the damage, but also how to deal with the vines that are damaged. And we conducted a lot of workshops just to show them how to prune the vines.
Our relationship with Ohio State goes way back in the 1980s. So we've had a long-standing relationship with ongoing research in the winery and in the vineyards. Currently, with Imed, Dami, our research has stemmed lately from the cold winter vortex, where we've had a lot of the vines killed and damaged from the minus 20 degree temperatures. Current research is was kind of involved to the extent of the damage to determine the actual damage, and to have pruning studies done to see what was the best way to prune these injured vines. We have not had temperatures that cold since 1994 here, and myself and a lot of the grape growers have not experienced this cold damage. So we need research to help us kind of figure out what's the next step and see what our future is in these vineyards.